This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video provides an overview of how to add users to REDCap projects and enter data. A REDCap administrator must create each person a REDCap user account on the server before they can be added to any project. Users can be assigned access to projects via the User Rights page, which is located on the menu to the left of the screen. Access can be given by assigning users to a user role or granting custom rights. Creating a user role is the fastest and most convenient way to mass assign users who need the same permissions within the project. To create a new role, enter the role name and click Create Role. The User Rights page also displays all options given to or restricted from a user. User expiration dates are optional and will automatically restrict project access after the assigned date. The highest level privileges include designing and modifying the project structure and setup, and assigning user rights and data access groups. The number of people who should have access to these highest privileges should be restricted to the project owner and a few trusted individuals who have been well trained on REDCap. It is also important to limit who has access to actions that can dramatically change a project and affect the integrity of the data, such as the data import tool, the data quality tool, the API, and actions for renaming and deleting records and exporting data. If giving data export rights, it is also essential to decide whether the user needs full access or if a de-identify dataset will suffice. To assign users to a role, search using their name, username, or email address. Click their name and choose which role to assign them to. Anyone added to a role will have the same user permissions as the others within that role. Administrators can edit or change a user's role to permit or limit additional actions in the project. Edit roles after they have been created by clicking on the red role name. Reassign users to another role or completely remove them from a role by clicking on their name and choosing Reassign to a role or Remove from role. To add a new user with custom rights, search for them, click on the user's name, and click Add with custom rights. This action will add the user, but will not assign them to a role. Users that are already added to a project can also be assigned to existing roles. Their custom rights can be edited by clicking on their name and choosing Edit User Privileges. User rights can be reviewed quickly by scrolling to the right. Data access groups, also known as DAGs, restrict which records users can view. DAGs are helpful in many circumstances. For example, suppose statewide data is being collected in a project, but access should be restricted so each region only sees the records they added. In that case, each region should be set up as a DAG. The DAG page is located next to User Rights on the left-hand side of the screen or the tab at the top of the screen. Creating a DAG is similar to creating user roles. The DAG must be created first, and then users can be added to the group. A DAG can be assigned as a record is being entered. Then, only users in the associated DAG have the ability to view that record. Users can add data to a project in several ways. Records are added when a REDCap user manually fills out a data entry form, a participant fills out a survey, or when records are imported through the data import tool. To manually add a record, click Add Edit Records, located on the left-hand side of the screen under the Data Collection section, and click Add New Record. This action will display the record overview, which includes the status of completion for each data collection instrument. If the project only has one data collection instrument, it will open to that instrument. To complete a record, open each instrument and fill it out. Within a data collection instrument in a new record, a data access group can be assigned by using the drop-down menu on the top right-hand corner of the record. Choose Complete at the bottom of the data collection instrument after data entry is complete. New records are created every time a participant submits a survey. Records can be imported through the Data Import tool. This advanced method imports a CSV file that contains the completed records. Click on Data Import tool located on the left-hand side of the screen. Follow the instructions on the page. It is important to note that the variable names and format of the CSV must be exactly the same as the data import template for the data to import successfully. This option can overwrite existing data in a project, so it is crucial to review the data before importing it. To find an existing record, search for the record on the Add Edit Records page. Select the record using the Choose an Existing Record ID dropdown or by querying a field in the data search box. To display all records within a project, click on the Record Status Dashboard on the left side of the screen under the Data Collection section. The dashboard displays colored circles that indicate whether an existing record is complete, partially complete, or incomplete. A legend describing completion status is located on the top right-hand side of the page. Clicking on status icons next to a record or clicking on the record's number will open a record. The colored buttons also provide information on how each instrument was filled out. A gray circle indicates no data was saved within that instrument. If the circle is a solid color other than gray, the instrument was filled out on the back end of REDCap as a data entry form. A circle with a check mark indicates that the instrument was filled out through a survey link. Specific user rights have to be assigned for a REDCap user to be able to edit records completed via surveys. This concludes the video on how to add users and enter data in a REDCap project. The next video in the series will focus on exporting and analyzing collected data.